Hey guys, Total Legion here, and welcome back to another video. Today we'll be playing some Napoleon online battles, and this is a replay from about 4 days ago, and it is with me, Tim, Wookie, Kaide, Harry, Nick, and Kyrtenn, and LonelyWolf, all of which are from the 59th, which is the regiment that I'm in for Mountain Blade, Napoleonic Wars. So if you're interested in joining a Napoleonic Wars regiment, then please go to the description and click on the first link. But anyways, so let's go over the army comps, and I think the battle's actually already started, but I've paused it just now so we can go over them. So I've got a pretty mixed comp. I've got a bit of every unit there is really in the game. So I've of course got the classic National Guards. Look at these guys. These guys are a pain to get rid of, but I'm going to be mainly using these as cannon fodder today more than anything, and I'm going to be using them to push up across this bridge. Let's see what else we got. We've got two Swiss foot, I think. Yep, two Swiss foot, and then four fusiliers of line. Actually, I think that could be five. One, two, three. It's five fusiliers of line, sorry. Some chasseurs and some more chasseurs. And then we have a rocket troop unit, just one. And on top of these guys, quite literally, we have some artillery à cheval, which of course is the horse artillery. And what is this guy doing? He's taking a bit of a dump. He's got a bit scared. He needs to go to the toilet. I think there's a bush over there, mate. But anyways, yeah, so we've got the horse artillery, which are very, very speedy. And yeah, but I've got them mounted up here, so they're getting ready to shoot. And that is that for my army. Let's go take a look at Tim. Tim has brought along some dragoon guards and some life guards and two dragoons. He has his general staff, my general's general staff as well. He has some light foot, some 9-pounders, and he has two of those foot, British foot, and he has some foot guards and two Highlander units. Look at these guys. Absolutely love the Highlander units. Look at their like models and stuff. It looks so good. And that is it for Tim's army, I'm pretty sure. And he has, obviously, some of these 5-inch houses. So, you may have noticed that the graphics have, like, gone up a bit. That was because I was playing in medium graphics throughout the whole last couple of videos. And I finally just realized, so I've boosted the graphics up to ultra, and it looks a ton better. So it should be a lot cooler to watch now. But anyways, let's go look at Wookie's army, I think this is. So what has Wookie brought? He's brought some Volta gears. He's got two of those. He has four of these fusiliers of line, and he has two old guy units. Let's take a look at these. Look at them. They do not break unless under very extreme circumstances. He's got two 12 pounders and some general staff and Volta gears, and that's it as far as Wookie's army is concerned. Let's take a look at Harry. This is Harry. He has a general staff unit. The 15th Hussars, the King's German Light Dragoons, the 42nd Foot, the Black Watch, the 88th Foot. A lot of elite units, actually. Really expensive army, wow. And then some Foot Guards and some Coldstream Guards. Whoa, he has really spent the money. And then some rifles, look at these. I am really liking the skirmishes a lot more. And he's got some King German Legion foot, and I think that's it for his army setup. Are the KGL flight foot, are they DLC? Because I'm really not too sure, but this guy's having a bit of a spasm, so let's go ahead and look at some more army. The rest of his army's got some 9-pounders and some Royal Scots Greys, I think I already mentioned them, and the rocket troops. And that is that for Harry's army and the allied forces. Let's go take a look at the enemies. I just bashed my desk, I do apologize. Let's go take a look at the enemies' army setups here. So this is Kaide. He has brought along some 9-pounders. He's got two 9-pounders, some Lightfoot, some British foot, and some more British foot over here. He's got some Lightfoot and then two of these KGL Legion Lightfoot. And some Dragoons, and I think, yep, some more Dragoons and General Staff. And that is it for his army. Nice and simple, kind of a classic British setup. So let's go take a look at the first Ottomans here. I'm not too sure who this is. I think this is Nick, maybe. But I could be wrong. Or maybe that's Nick. I think Nick is France, actually. And this must be Kyrtenn. So this is Kyrtenn playing as the Ottomans here. He's got some Delhi horsemen. He's got some 9-pounders, some seeded infantry. He's got some janissaries. I think he's got four of those, or three of those actually, and some more infantry, and his general's bodyguard, and some 18 pounders. These things look amazing. Just look at the detail gone into like the cannon and stuff. It looks really cool. He's got some of these Azars, and he's got one of those, and then some, God, I don't even know, Sapphire cavalry, I think. Sapphire, I don't know. And some more Delhi horsemen, and that is that for Kyrtenn's setup. Let's take a look at the second French army on the battlefield, and this is going to be run by Nick. And he has brought along some dragoons, some fusiliers of line. He's got quite a few of those. He's got five fusiliers of line and some dragoons. And then he's moved right up here already. And he's got two old guards standing right at the front here. And I think they're facing the wrong way. And I actually think that Nick didn't know which way we'd be coming from. So that is why he deployed like this. So a bit of a botch on his part. And his old guard are going to get hammered by my artillery straight off the bat. I've already done a couple of shots, and I think we already took out a couple. Yeah, there we go. We already took out one of his men manning the artillery pieces. So let's take a look. He's got two 12-pounders, and that is that for his army. And then, obviously, general staff. Oh, dear, he's lost someone already. So let's take a look at LonelyWolf's army. And he's got some seated mounted infantry. He's got some general bodyguard, the Azars, and some seated rifles, and then he has some more seated infantry, and then some more mounted seated horsemen, and I think that's that. So there we go, let's get started. We've already taken up 7 minutes of the deployment stages. So let's go ahead and start and see if we can get some battles going. So here they are, the just says getting ready to make their way across the bridge. First couple of shots to see where they land. The French and Ottomans bunched up very nice, which will allow us to get some shots off into their infantry early on, causing some to lose. Also already started hitting his horses with my rockets. Let's see if we can get another volley coming over here in a sec. I don't want to wait too long, so I don't want to miss all the action on the other side. So he has pushed this cavalry right back, and I think they're actually out of range of my units. Yes, they are. So let's take a look at this. Whoa, that guy went flying. Well, there we go. We have completed the mission of finding the person who goes flying in the video, and we've done that already. It's very early on. So yeah, I've got the depth of field turned on as well. It just looks really, really cool when, you know, you've got artillery pieces exploding and stuff. So that's pretty nice feature. It just basically focuses in on the nearer objects and kind of blurs out the stuff in the distance. As you see, you've got these rockets coming for a huge volley here. Look at that. Crazy. So yeah, tell me what you guys think about having the depth of field turned on. I think it looks pretty cool, but I will obviously turn it off if it gets annoying. So Tim has already started his bombardment on two LonelyWolf's Ottomans over there. It was five-inch howitzers. Not much is going on over in the middle. Wookie's pushed up and they're starting to fight across this river here from house to house. Oh my god. Oh dear. This farmhouse is all but gone. A lot of guys just lost their lives in there then from this couple of artillery shots, but battle's still continuing. Point blank range here coming from the 9-pounders. And the Ottomans doing very well so far, keeping the French at bay. He has lost a lot of men. There is three different units in here. They're all Volunteers. But that is a lot of men he's lost. He's lost about 10 in each. That is not good. But anyway, the bombardments come from all artillery pieces, some from the UK and some from France here. Just trying to get a bit of consolation for that loss that Wookie just suffered. And then there's the Snake Charmer's flute, as I like to call it. Look at that. Let's take a look over here. Not much going on. Bit of a standpoint, really, for me and Nick and LonelyWolf. I had to go up against two people in all reality here. I had to go up against two, but I did have Tim to help me out. which was always good. So I'm really just forming up my guys here to get ready to head across the bridge. Because the Ottomans didn't have any artillery, it was kind of safe to me to, you know, bunch up my guys like this. And France had obviously that deployment botch, so I could really just do whatever I wanted for the first couple of 15 minutes or so. Look at the artillery just raining down. But I did find it wiser to move them back up onto the hill a little bit. And there we go, look at them, they are ready. The fusiliers of line are ready to cross that bridge and win for Emperor Napoleon. Gonna move up my artillery pieces here. I'll just show you the speed on these things. If you do ever play as France, I really recommend bringing 5-pounders. They are so useful. But anyways, we're gonna start moving across in a sec here. I think I've already... Oh yeah, I'm just forming up my National Guard, and they are gonna be the cannon fodder, like I said. But the main fighting force of these fusiliers are just moving up, getting ready to cross that bridge. Let's just take a look at the National Guard forming up. Look at these guys with the little hats. Look amazing. Got another line coming in here. Let's take a look at this rocket. See what happens with this. Where's it going? Ooh, onto the Ottoman horses. I don't think we've got any kills in that volley, though. They are surrounded by trees. Oh, there goes one building. That's the first building gone. And that one's gone as well. It's a bit of a firefight coming across this bridge, but obviously these are the Voltigeurs that sadly lost a lot of their brothers in that first building. And I think we might see a melee charge here in a sec, so I don't want to miss that, but I'll come back to that and see what happens. So I'm just sending across my Jassers here and just kind of pushing up as much as I can, seeing as there's no real dangers in this whole area. There is a lot of hidden Ottoman infantry in these trees, however, so I do need to watch out for that. And now I'm just sending across my National Guard. And they are going to be, again, my cannon fodder more than anything. Another rocket's just coming up there. We'll see if we can get a thumbnail in a sec. Probably won't be able to. But it'd be cool if we could. There we go, that'd be good. There we go. Perfect. Okay. So, I'm going to send across my fusiliers of line. Look at the big line here. Actually, it could be cool to get another picture, just in case that first one doesn't come out as well as I thought it would. There you go. Look at them. I really also wanted to kind of have some sort of realism to the my battle at least, so that's why I formed them up like this. Just made them slowly walk across. Because, you know, I had an opportunity to really have a bit of a mess around because they weren't being too aggressive on my flank, at least. We'll go take a look at what Kaide and Harry are up to in a sec, because I'm sure they're already fighting. As another rocket barrage comes in onto his artillery, and France finally set up their troopers into a good position. But I've managed to hide my my chasseurs down here behind this hill, so no artillery is going to get into that. I've also moved my 5-pounders onto this little hill ledge here, and I'll be able to just fire over to them in a couple of seconds. But let's go take a look at what Harry and Kaide are getting up to. Not too much. They must have been waiting back a bit or been assisting over in this middle, which I think they might have been doing. But oh my god, what an artillery shot there. And then just the volleys from the KGL Lightfoot. Harry so far doing a good couple of shots, and they have really messed up this Lightfoot unit. Look at that. They were full. Oh my god, that was a pretty good volley there, but now Kaide is returning fire. However, the bridge will be protecting Harry. Protecting, even. I don't think I said it right. So, France, again, holding off, just kind of using their artillery, which is expected. The same with Tim over here. Me and Tim haven't really been too aggressive this game. I'm going to send around some of these fusiliers of line just to kind of scout out the area and also get a kind of a flank around my opponent if possible. I do need to watch out for these units of horses over here. as they could easily come in for a charge at any point. And here are the hidden units I was telling you about. But they are going to retreat as I do push up. Which was a bit of a mistake for me, because there were more units and I kind of just got mowed down. So I did decide to retreat back to my rifles. Oh dear, and a bit of friendly fire coming in from Tim. Oh dear. Oh dear, but they are going to be okay. Well, at least some of them are, going to be okay. He lost about four of his own men there. Poor Tim. Oh well. Not much going on in the middle. Still a bit of a standoff for this bridge. The fight for the bridge is continuing. Harry is holding on very well, considering he only has two units here. I think that's three. Sorry, there's a hidden unit here. Holding up against some of these dragoons, but a bit of a mistake there from Kaide, and he does lose one of his dragoon units. And he's about to lose another if he's not careful. Harry is doing very well though, keeping that left flank out of solid. He's also got these guys who I think are hidden still. So the 88th are doing good. Tim is slowly moving his guys up. And I think there'll be a battle here in a sec between France and Tim. I'm just continuing the barrage of artillery fire from both my rockets and my 5-pounders here. So yeah, here are the rockets coming across to hit Lonely Wolf's horses. And we killed about two, I think, altogether there with those two rocket fires. But that's good, because rockets do affect their morale as well. I've got this chassis set up, and I think Lonely's going to try and cross this bridge over here. And I do see that coming, so I do move my my spare fuse, I think it's my Swiss foot I move, to help my chassis from being killed. And we'll take a look at that, because it's pretty epic. That is my phone vibrating, so I'm going to put that somewhere else. Barrage of rocket fire going on to that general. He was lost a lot of men there. The Ottomans really do have to be careful in this one, otherwise they are going to lose a lot of morale from their general's death. So yeah, this is when I see Lonely coming across the bridge. I'm just going to pull back my light infantry. Much says who are for some reason walking. And now here come the Swiss foot over to assist in the saving of the Jesus. Yeah, for some reason I thought it would be good to move them around here. I don't know why I did that. We have killed it was because I thought he was now going for my my rocket troops, and he was actually going to go for my rocket troops. And you'll see that here in a sec. Here it comes. Missing wildly with those rockets there. But yeah, let's take a look at this. I don't really want to... we're not going to focus on to those rockets. So I send up my Swiss over there, and I send my spare fusiliers of line back to help here. And obviously these other mounted rifles, so the mounted seated rifles, they can get some shots off. But I managed to turn around in time and get a couple of shots off on my own. As you'll see here in a sec. Because of him failing to maneuver his men, I do get a nice couple of hits off on him. There we go. Sorry, I'm just really wanting to get a couple of good screenshots for the thumbnail. Alright, so let's take a look over here. Over on the left flank, let's take a look. So more rockets coming in from Wookie. He really is just trying to kill as many as he possibly can. A lot of the buildings have been destroyed. And Harry has managed to win the fight for the bridge, and he is now sending forth all of his men. A bit of a risky move, if you ask me. Definitely a risky move, as now Kaide is advancing up to meet Harry. I think Harry is sending across some cav though. Yeah, he's got some. He's got the 15th Hussars coming in. Pretty risky move, but yeah, here is my cannon fodder of a National Guard coming up to take on the Fusiliers of Line. And they're being shot from all angles. But again, they are just cannon fodder to allow my other men to move up to a better position. And we do get the hill advantage here. And I think we get a couple shots off. I think. Let's have a look. Let's take a look from their perspective here. And they're going to come in for a melee charge. And there we go. We have engaged in melee and I get the downhill charge bonus. And you'll see me now charging into his Azars, which isn't the best of ideas considering they are melee units. Yeah, Harry has pushed across the bridge. Kaide has kind of held his position a bit. But Harry's getting a bit close. A bit too close for comfort as he's getting shot from the side. His men are pretty clumped up. And he could do with possibly thinning these lines out a bit more. But it seems to be working so far. The morale of Kaide's Brits is very low. And 42nd. Look at these guys. Look amazing. And they are kind of head glitching a bit. But whatever. Some friendly cav. Is this friendly cav? I don't think this is friendly cav. Oh, it is. Running, it is friendly cav. Friendly cav coming across the bridge. Harry has done a really good move there. He's sending his cav across to melee charge into Cade's army. And he's managing to rout them. And Kaide is all but out here if he isn't careful. So my National Guard did die, but they did put a bit of a puncher into those Fusiliers. And this is where I actually requested that Tim charged his cav into those light infantry over here, because they're not being protected by anything at all apart from these stakes. And this is also kind of a bit of cannon fodder kind of style technique here, because this does allow me to push over my Fusiliers and such. And you'll see here in a sec that I'm going to start moving my guys up to actually meet against LonelyWolf and Nick here. So let's take a look at this melee charge. So he fakes the charge onto these Azars. And then he fakes the charge again over to the Fusiliers. And he comes in. And let's have a look. Oh, look at that. And he's just going to one by one start to rout these guys. And he got very lucky, very, very lucky here with these states. Because they weren't really deployed correctly. So you'll see that he doesn't actually lose too many guys. Granted, he loses a couple there, but I think that's all. Yeah, he lost one person from that stake, and now he can just charge into these Azars as he likes. I'm sorry, Azars aren't melee troops. I am very sorry about that. I should have known that. It's just they look like the Janissaries. So here I am, just moving up my Fusiliers. And they're going to take on Nick's Fusiliers whilst he's being bombarded with artillery. And the Dragoon Guards are just going to one by one take out those stragglers. Bit of a mistake from Nick, sorry, coming off of that hill. Because this does allow me to get the flank on him. He gets the first volley, but let's have a look, see what happens here. Oh, look at the slaughter of French men. And we'll see them fall down here in a sec. There we go, they've gone. And we can just finish off these last Fusiliers there. So, Harry has done very well on this left flank. He's eliminated Kaide, and now this will allow him to move across this bridge and into enemy territory, into the back of the enemy lines. The Ottomans are slowly retreating across as well, as only one of Tim's Dragoon Guards is a Dragoon Guard unit. One Dragoon Guard unit has managed to make the Ottomans retreat, which is pretty amazing. So I'm just going to move up. My guys have done pretty well. Being very aggressive on this right flank compared to what the middle has been, but they have managed to gain a lot of ground in the middle, considering there isn't much ground to gain. But of course, there is still the old guard in reserve here for Nick. And they are not something I want to be going up against. Just look at this flag. The French fighting the French. The rebellious. Rebellious is like the word. Oh my god, I don't think it is. The rebellers. There you go. That's what they are. Interesting formation going on here, but you know, it seemed to be working for Harry. He's managed to take out Kaide, so anything is possible. But here comes a cav charge across the bridge. The foot guards are going to get into square formation just in time. And oh dear, what a slaughter. And they're routed before they can even get to any action at all. And now we're fighting across the river itself here. We're already taking that one artillery piece, and we're now going to go for another. And here come the old guard, looking to save the day. But that artillery is now routed, and that is it as far as the artillery goes for the right flank, or their left flank. And now Nick is having one last attempt to retake this middle area here, or try and take this middle, but he isn't going to have much success, especially with 60 guys shooting you whilst you're crossing this bridge, and even more, you got the Highland Foot here. And it's just an easy way to kill them. One by one, they're going to start routing. And down go those Fusiliers, and now there is one last Fusilier of line unit. Are they going to get a volley off? Yes, they are, and you can say goodbye to those. So, here come the old guard. Here they come, and he has charged his general into my guys, but I got into square just in time, so I don't have to worry about that. And here I am now, sending across my Swiss foot, my final reserves. Got no one left to really commit now. And the old guard are going to go straight for my Fusiliers of line. It's going to be an easy win for them, as far as that little battle goes there. But I'm going to stay in square formation. Because I don't want any more cav coming in. Because I know Lonely still has some cav. But this does actually allow me to start shooting at the old guard. Even if it is just wasting ammo. But Tim comes in. Look at that. What a charge from Tim. He does lose a couple of guys from those stakes there. But he has charged in. Which buys me a little more time. And it's a bit of an old guard sandwich. They don't really know what they're doing, and I'm wasting a lot of ammo with these guys. And here comes another cav charge from Tim. And he's going to lose a couple more guys from those stakes. And they are very well hidden. And I think they've finally disappeared. Finally broken. But my men routing isn't too much to worry about, because the goons have surrounded the old guard. They are just trapped. And there is no escaping from there. So let's have a look. Harry is now pushed up even more. He's gone straight up for these Ottomans. Very aggressive, but it is working very well for him. And he's managed to trap them just like the old guard have been trapped. And he's also getting rid of the artillery units. And the rocket's just continuing to bombard here. Let's see where this one goes. I think this one's coming for his old guard, or it was going for his old guard until they moved. So, bit of a waste there. But there go the old guard. They are finally broken. And our men can reform as Tim sends his men across the bridge to assist Harry in
glorious victory, sir. He's soon to be
getting rid of the Ottomans. But they are very well hidden in this forest here. The last couple of guys. And then his general unit over here. This is a British general that's going for the Hussars. Wow. Oh, sorry, not the Hussars, the Musketeers. Look at them, brave general unit. And a lot of friendly fire does cause the British general to die. Oh dear, friendly fire, but there you go. That middle section has been won, and now it is down to Lonely Wolf and the Ottomans. And I think what we'll do is speed this up a little bit, because there is a lot of waiting. And it would be a bit of a waste considering this video is nearly up to 30 minutes. But yeah, so let's take a look now as I put it back to normal. So the Ottomans are having one last stand against three very, well, still very strong armies. We haven't really lost a lot of our guys. We've done very well in this one. And I actually feel like I have played a big part in this battle for once. So it's a bit of a change. But here comes the rockets now. Look at that. As me and Tim start to line up for the final couple of minutes are about to happen in this battle, because we are ready to mow down some guys. I already got some of my artillery pulled up here as well. Okay. Oh, look at that. Very lucky. A lot of artillery firing at them. And Britain's even coming in. They want their share of the last couple of minutes. They're coming in from this far side to try and help us take out these last remaining Ottomans who have really been cowered in for the most part of this battle. And just shots coming in from either side. Not much the Ottomans can really do in this situation. So my Swiss foot are being moved up onto the hill. They haven't seen much action at all throughout this whole battle. We're only losing about 2 or 4 for each of these units. So you have them very well. But we are going to do a melee charge now to finish off this battle. A nice volley there from the Swiss foot. As we now engage in melee. And here come the Swiss foot also going for a melee charge against his mounted seedits there. The Ottoman has just been hammered by my rockets still. These guys are just walking, look at them. They don't care, they're gonna walk. So are my Swiss foot apparently. It's a good little march and something. That guy's worn out. He is really worn out. And there we go. That is that. The last general unit. And I think there's some cavalry and the Azars. So that is it. The Ottomans are finally fallen. And we have had victory. A very impressive victory as well. Very convincing victory. We didn't lose too many men, to be honest. I don't think any of my guys routed, now I think about it. Actually, no, my National Guard, but that doesn't really matter. So, yeah. So, let's look at the teams. Oh, we actually did have Kaide on our team. My mistake. I thought it was either Kaide or Harry. So, it was Kaide who was playing on our team. It was Kaide who pushed across that river there and did take out Harry. So yeah, he deployed 546 people. We had Wookie playing as France, who deployed 648. Tim deployed 616, and I deployed 856. So I deployed the most. Did I lose the most? For my team, I did, but that was because of the National Guard more than anything. So let's have a look at the other team. Harry deployed 716, Kyrtenn deployed 710, and Nick deployed 656, and Lonely deployed 796. So they really had the numbers advantage on us, at least. Let's see who lost the most for their team. That would be Kyrtenn. Kyrtenn lost the most for their team, but only just. Nick nearly came close to losing the most as well. Let's see who got the most kills. That would be Kaide, obviously, with that push across the bridge against Harry. He did get a lot of kills there. So let's take a look at the unit statistics. And let's see who leveled up the most. So my artillery, but I think they were already that level. So let's see if we can find one. The fuses align here that leveled up. Who got the most kills? I imagine, yep, my fuses aligned, they were. Put this used a lot. And my rocket troops getting 45 kills. That's pretty decent for rocket troops. Not gonna lie. So yeah, there we have it, guys. I do hope you guys enjoyed this video. And yeah, so I've got another video coming out tomorrow, I think, or the day after. So I've got another Napoleon video that I need to release. So it should be cool. So like I said, guys, thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys next time.